the second installment of Wardrobe Week. If you missed the first video, I will link that up here. It's like a wardrobe clear out, tidy up tips kind of video, so that is there. But today is gonna be a shoe collection video. Now, I've meant to do this for the longest time, but I think today is the day. Well, I know it's gonna happen today because I'm doing it right now, but two things to note before I start. Number one, my shoe collection is kind of on the small side of things, and that is because we live in quite a tiny flat and I just don't have the space to have oodles and oodles of shoes. Who knows, one day maybe I will have, but right now I have to keep it kind of on the very condensed, well-edited side. And also, number two, I go through shoes so quickly. I'm so heavy on my feet. If you ever meet me, I'm the one like scuffing my feet on the floor as I walk along. And so I may have owned more shoes in the past, but it's not unheard of for them to become a non-watertight, wholly sold option, and they just gotta go. So this is what I have currently in my wardrobe right now. I think there's about 12 pairs. Let's do this. I feel like firstly I have to address these, the Ash Jalouse boots, which I am just absolutely obsessed with. I wear them in the winter, I wear them in the summer, I am just all round in love with these boots. Now, they were quite pricey, so I do like to wear them a lot just to get my money's worth out of them, but I feel like I definitely well and truly have, because they are so comfortable. They are not comfortable at first, they take like a few days of wearing in, and then it's literally like putting slippers on. And I like that they've just got a slight heel on the back. I always just feel a bit more comfortable with a heeled boot. I feel like it's more flattering, and the cut on the front is very flattering on the legs. It elongates them. Now, I do also have them in grey, but I don't wear these as often. I did think when I purchased them both that I would wear these more often, but actually I really like the beigey shade, because I wear a lot of black. It's quite nice to break it up with. It's not colour, but you know, a different neutral. But same thing goes for these. Very comfortable once you've worn them in. Love, love, love. I've just realised that I'm missing two pairs of boots, because they are up there in my wardrobe in my winter wardrobe boxes, which if you saw my last video will make sense to you, so I'll be back.
Whoa.
Now, these are the highest boots that I own. They're from Whistles, and I think they're called the Canter Jopper Ankle Boots or something. I think they still got them on ASOS, even though I got them last winter. And they are very nice indeed. These are my more slightly fancier boots, because they're higher, they're a little bit more dressier. They're definitely not the most comfortable, but they are uncomfortable because of their height in the heels. Actually, inside the padding on the bottom of the sole is actually quite nice. Then I said I didn't like flat boots, but you do have to have a pair of flat boots just for when there's occasions where wearing a heel all day just isn't very appropriate. And these are also from Whistles. Can't remember the name of them. We'll see if I can find a link below. I love the colour of these. I really like quite a pale camel-y boot almost. I feel like there may be some more added to the collection this winter, but they're very similar to the other ones that I've got from Whistles, but just with a flat kind of heel. Same detailing. Really find these very comfortable indeed. Now, rounding off the boot section, we have my Wellington boots, which are very well worn and very dirty indeed. They're from Hunter, and I think they're called the Festival Short or something like that. I got them a long time ago, probably about 2 or 3 years ago now, and they were a really good purchase because I've got so much wear out of these. Whenever it's raining, I'm like, right, out these come. If I'm going camping, they come with me. If I'm doing like an outdoor walk, they come with me. They're just really great boots. Shall we touch on trainers? Because I have two pairs. These first ones are my running trainers, and I got fitted out for these at a place called Run in Hove, which is amazing. If you're into running and you live in the Brighton and Hove area, I definitely suggest getting yourself down there, because they properly fitted me out for these, saw what my foot was doing when it hit the ground when I was running, and they are incredible. Before I had these, I was running in my night free runs, and they just weren't half as comfortable with these. They're pretty bulky, but you get a lot of support, and I no longer struggle with, I was getting a lot of shin splints in my Nikes. Don't have that problem at all with these, and I have been running faster since I have these, so there you go. Just realised I haven't said what they are. They are called Asics, I think, and they are the GT2000s. Now, these are pretty battered. They are my Nike Free Run. I think they're called 5.0 Plus. They no longer do this design anymore. It's been discontinued, and you can find it on the odd sports outlet-y website, but actually on the official Nike website, they no longer exist. And I'm so sad, because I was very tempted to pick up a second pair. These are unfortunately well on their way out, mainly because I have worn them without socks one too many times, and being too close to them right now is not a very pleasant experience, but they are just so comfortable. I was never a trainers girl at all. Until this year, I don't think I'd owned a pair of trainers since I was 16 and in school and you had to have them for PE. I was just not into trainers at all, but ever since I bought these, they are incredible. When you're running errands or you're just going down the shop or you're doing your food shop, amazing, absolutely amazing. I'm completely a trainers convert and I will definitely be picking up some more styles. I fancy a few like more colourful ones. I love them. Now I actually only have one pair of sandals. One pair of sandals. And please don't look at these too closely because they're extremely battered. They're from Aldo. I got them a long, long time ago. But they are so comfortable and I've just worn them in so much that the leather doesn't pinch around the toes or anything like that. They are basically just like putting slippers on. And I'm not really a sandals girl. I love a good boot in the winter and in the summer actually. So I don't really like sandals too much on my feet. I find that I have quite long, thin feet and they make my feet look a bit like boats. But these aren't too bad, and if you're going on holiday, these are what are coming with me. Now I'm not a huge daily wearer of heels, but I do love them every now and again, especially if I'm going out. That is how I differentiate an everyday outfit to a nighttime one. I wear it basically exactly the same and stick a pair of heels on. And I like quite simple classic styles, nothing too fancy that's going to be quite trendy right now but isn't really going to be in next summer. So these are all ones that hopefully I will wear for years to come, and this is probably the most classic of all. These are from Whistles and they're just a court shoe. I actually have a really similar pair from ASOS that I can't find. I think a friend may have adopted those, but these are great. They just look so nice with jeans and they just really dress any outfit up. They've just got a very thin heel on the back, they're suede. I'm not really sure what else to say about them except for the fact that they're definitely not the most comfortable of shoe, but I'm working on still kind of breaking them in. Now I do love a good strappy stiletto and I have two pairs. The first ones are actually the newest addition to my shoe collection. They're from ASOS. Can't remember the exact name, but like all of these shoes, if I can find them online I'll pop a link below. And they actually have my party feet. Who else is a fan of the old party feet? Got those in the front to make them a little more comfortable because they most definitely were not comfortable at all. I've just seen they've got grass on the back. Wore them to a wedding on grass. Big mistake. I was like slowly sinking in for the whole day, but they're very beautiful indeed. Not very comfortable, but very aesthetically pleasing. Some similar ones are also from ASOS. I think these are called the Hoxton heels. Again, not particularly comfortable, but very nice looking on the feet. I just like very simple shoes, and I feel like you can't really get much more simple than just a black strappy stiletto. Now, keeping up with the pairs theme, I have two pairs that are more of a daytime heel. They're quite chunky in their heel and they're not too high, and they also look very, very similar. The first pair, picked these up last summer and got a lot of wear out of them. They're from And Other Stories and they're just this amazing like turquoise block heel. Now this is kind of as crazy as my shoe collection gets, but I love these. I love that on the back they go all the way up to the ankle and then you have this gold ankle strap. You know, I love a bit of gold, and they're just a little strappy bit at the front. Like I said, these were very well worn last summer and I've started cracking them out again. And I just love them. They're very, very comfortable. They did do them in black as well at the time, and I always was like, damn it, Anna, why didn't you get the black? These are a great kind of summer sandal everyday heel. Then I saw these. These are from Zara and they are very, very, very similar. You have the gold detailing again around the ankle, the little strap at the front, the very chunky heel at the back, and they are basically exactly the same aside from the fact that you don't have that sort of column at the back. Again, very comfortable, again very simple, but I love these as like an everyday heel choice when I need to look a little bit more fancier than just wearing my normal boots. And that concludes my shoe collection. So like I said, kind of short and sweet, but they're all shoes that I get a lot of wear out of and I just love very dearly. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this. On Sunday there will be a wardrobe tour coming, so if you want a better look around this, then that is coming for you. I'm quite excited about that one, but until then, have a great week. Bye.